We are in live.
Good morning, viewers. Good morning, participants. Thanking God Almighty again for this new day. Today, as I am going to be the resource trainer for today, there is no need for introduction of myself. Straight away, we can into the program. And today's topic is making the most of your interviews. That is a topic today we are planning to discuss. Successful interviews. In other words, you can say, because this topic is very, very essential for every graduate's life, actually. It is an important event, actually. This event, once this particular graduate who can successfully come across this event only can able to settle himself in life or whatever it may be. So, the important place where you have to perform. As Shakespeare told, this world is a stage and every humans are actors and God is the director. As per his direction, we are coming and acting in front of others. And once our chapter closed, we are winding up. So that's how Shakespeare told about this world and human life, actually. Like the way a stage, an important stage in your lifetime is this particular stage. That is what successfully, interview. How to make the most of the interviews? When interview took places, for example, if there is a call for from a company for about five vacancies, definitely the applications are more than five. As far as our country, the competition is hectic, and for five positions, there will be, depends upon the company, 500 to 1,000 applications will be forwarded for that, for to catch that five positions, actually. And as far as the competition is like that, actually. So there are hundreds of people appearing for that five positions, and only five was five can able to catch that. And who is that five? And what is the problem with the remaining 95? Why this 95 failed? Why this five succeeded? That is the point today we are going to discuss in this interview succession. Before I would like to share the screen with you, I would like to tell about the types of interviews, actually. There are, 1 second. Hope you are able to view my slide. Right. As far as this interview is concerned, there are two types of, category wise, we can categorize into two types. One is knowledge-based interview. And another one is competency-based interview. You have to have the clear justification among these two interviews. What is knowledge-based interview and what is competency-based interviews? Knowledge-based interviews, for example, you are studying from school, you are studying from colleges, and you are having a degree. And now with the degree, you are appearing for the interview. As what we discussed yesterday in emotional intelligences, people should carry their IQ as well as EQ to the interview panel. Where in knowledge-based interviews, your IQ will be viewed more curiously. Whereas your competency-based interviews, in your competency-based interviews, your EQs or EI, emotional intelligences, will be viewed very curiously. Then what are all the knowledge-based interview and what are all the competency-based interviews? Where are all the knowledge-based interviews took place? Where are all took place? You yourself know. For example, where are all people working or using their knowledge every day? People working for some institution, some organization, they are supposed to use their knowledge every day, actually. Where are all they are working? For example, schools. If you are appearing for a school interview, If you are appearing for a college interview as a faculty, as a professor, as a lecturer, as a teacher, then the management of that particular institution will definitely view your knowledge in a thorough manner. Actually, they want to have a clear picture about your knowledge, your aptitude. Got my point? Your knowledge-based interview. Sometimes you may come across, there are institutions, if they are selecting professors, lecturers, they used to ask the particular personality to conduct the class also. How they are conducting the class, what is their subject knowledge. That's how they will be, you know, finalizing, they will be selecting their candidates. That is one knowledge-based candidate. And what are all the other knowledge-based places? Programmers, computer software engineers, those who are working for softwares, designers. Now, all these people are related with the knowledge based, because what they have studied in the school, what they have studied in the college, they are going to apply. For example, a doctor. A doctor is appearing for an interview with a hospital, leading hospital. How the process will be, it is definitely a knowledge based actually. All professionals, like the other day we have discussed about various professionals like doctors, engineers, lawyers, auditors, teachers, all these professional based interviews will took place purely on the base of knowledge actually. And there are some other category that is another category is EA based, competency based interviews, where every day you are going to apply only your competencies, not the knowledge what you have gained in the college or the knowledge you gained in the school days actually. So what are all those works? You know, you have to categorize that, you have to define that. What are all competency based work? For example, every day for a college professor, there is no need to show much competency among the students actually. His prime responsibility is to share the knowledge actually. As the other day I told, you know, there is a difference. What is the difference between teachers, trainers and mentors? What we have discussed, you know, what is the role of a trainer actually? What is the role of a teacher? Teacher can share knowledge actually. Excuse me, please hold on. So hope you are viewing the slide. The problem is, since we are all in the quarantine, up to 2 o'clock, only the vendors can sell their products actually. So there is from morning till 2 o'clock, the roads are busy with a lot of vendors actually. They are coming with their mic sets, announcements and all, publicity advertisements all took place. So that's what I have closed every window and again I'm coming back. So coming back to the point, knowledge-based interview and competency-based interview. So for the professional applications, people were very keen on checking your knowledge, and for all other related jobs, for all other related careers, people in the interview panel, they will more keen on checking your emotional intelligences. That is the reason yesterday we have discussed about the emotional intelligence. And today the overview, what are all the points today we are going to discuss is preparing for the interview. Preparation is the key to success for anything actually, as we discussed many times. So the entire this particular webinar made for making you to prepare yourself for a successful career. So preparing for the interviews, because without preparation, you cannot kill the interview. So the interview experiences, the second point today we are going to discuss is about the interviewing experience. What kind of experience you will feel, you are going to feel with the interview actually. And the third important point we are going to discuss, questions to expect and to ask. What kind of, there are some ready-made questions are available actually. You can anytime expect these questions from the interviewer, and how you can expect and how you can answer those questions and what kind of questions you may ask to the interviewer. Those things we will discuss in that particular point. Different types of interview. As we know, only face-to-face interview. There are a lot other types of interview took place, especially during this COVID-19. You know, nowadays there is no one-to-one discussion, direct interview, physical interviews are taking place. There are a lot of other modes of interviews are taking place. What are all the other types of interviews available and how we have to perform to those interviews also? And what is the meaning of assessment centers? There are a lot of assessment centers are helping to took place a lot of interview sessions, psychometric tests related with, now apart from, this is the third level of interview, knowledge-based interview, skill-based interview, competency-based interview, and another one is psychometric test-related interview, where your arithmetic-related intelligence get checked, actually. So today, this is our overview. We are going to discuss about these kind of things. Now, the purpose of today's session is all the graduates who are attending, all the participants who are attending and who are going to watch this particular program, they have to hit their target with a proper. How to conduct an employer-focused job search. That's how we are going to start this session. How to conduct an employer-focused job search. Now you can imagine this. You can see this picture. The cart before the horse. Trying to be everything to everyone results in being nothing to everyone. Because updation of resume, the other day we have discussed about selling yourself. Because why we have discussed the other day about selling yourself? Because you want to sell yourself successfully in this particular day, in this interview day. That is the reason we have discussed certain things related with the selling yourself. And we have discussed about the skills. And we have discussed about the types of resumes, types of presentations, the way you have to present to the interviewer and all other aspects. There are three types of resume also we have seen. One is chronological, another one is functional, and another one is hybrid resume. Among these three, and we were suggested you to go with the functional resume, functional resume. So before you update your resume, now we are speaking about the preparation. Now we are entering into the preparation chart. Before you update your resume, identify the job and the employer. Who is, what is my job and who is my employer? You have to identify. That is very, you know, blindly, if you are, you know, applying yourself with the job sites, will pumping you a lot of job opportunities. You have to analyze, you have to identify whether which job will suit for you, and you have to analyze and which employer can takes you to the brightest career of yourself. So before you update your resume, identify the job and employer, and after that, customize your resume to convince the hiring manager that you are uniquely qualified for that position. That we already discussed, you know, in that functional resume, how you can selling yourself in that particular chapter. We have seen much about that functional resume. So I have given a brief discussion about that also, because one particular resume for all kinds of job, nothing will work out actually, because you are having certain things, certain inputs, and you want that particular input to fit in for the employer. No, every employer, every designation, every job description is having its own expectation. When every unique company, every organization is having unique expectation, then your resume should have that unique feature to fulfill that expectation, actually. That is the reason I put this particular word, trying to be everything to everyone. You are having something to all, then the result will be nothing to everyone. So the first prime point we are discussing about the preparation is your resume preparation. So identify what is the job, identify who is your employer, identify what are all the skills needed. Accordingly, you position your resume. That is the first key for preparation. And the important 30 seconds. I was conducting a lot of interviews for various companies in my country. Honestly speaking, 30 seconds to 40 seconds are more than enough for us to identify a personality, a candidate. And we people are not having the, you know, we are having very limited time. Because for selecting 10 candidates, there might be 100, 150 candidates. I am supposed to meet all the 150 candidates in a scheduled time. You think of my intention. Being an employer side, being a human resource, I have to see all the 150 candidates before this evening, 3 o'clock. Then how much time I will spend for a candidate? Minutes. Only few minutes. That few minutes are important in your life. How you are going to perform in that few minutes about yourself. That is the key point of success. So, the 30 seconds are very, very important. How you are entering, how you are receiving us, and how you are taking your seat, how you are sitting, and how you are handshaking, how your eye contact, all those things can be able to watch by the interviewer within 30 seconds. That 30 seconds is the key time for the shortlisting the candidates for a interviewer. What do you mean by employer center approach? First, identifying prospective employers. Who is that employer? Identifying prospective employer. Okay, who is that employer? That employer want your unique skills and expertise. That employment and that employer, they are in the want. They are in the need of the skills and expertise what you are having. That is the meaning of identification. Not identifying prospective employers in the sense, not identifying this employer, that employer, this employer, that employer. Instead, what is the need of that employer? What is what that employer wants? Whether his need and want, am I having anything to fulfill his need and want? Then you will be the solution provider for their problems, for their need and wants. That is the meaning of identifying prospective employers. So first, identifying prospective employers, that employer want your unique skills and expertise. That is your uniqueness. Then package yourself as a solution to their specific challenges. Because they are having some specific challenges to overcome. That is the reason they are conducting this particular interview to shortlist some candidates for fulfilling that specific challenges with success. So they want solution for their specific challenges. They don't want a normal people, normal graduate to giving a solution to their specific challenge. They want people with the skills and expertise. That is the reason the whole webinar we are considering about the intelligence, emotional intelligence, soft skills, hard skills, what kind of skills you have to develop to become more career success and all. The most effective job search campaigns recognize the employer's needs, reflect their priorities, and focus on solutions in the form of candidates' expertise. So that is the meaning of employer center approach, my dear participants. Read the job postings very, very carefully. We usually read the designation, very keen on seeing the salary, what is the monetary benefits am I having, and where is the place of my posting actually, where I am going to get placed actually. That's all. What is the name of the company, which industry it belongs to? That's all. Okay, assistant manager for a reputed bank, or salary $2,500. Okay, let us apply for this job. That is not the way you have to present yourself for assistant manager to your bank actually. So job postings are the key area you have to come to by the way of seeing the job postings itself. You can come to the conclusion that am I fit to this job or not actually. Because all those information are readily available in the job postings in almost all the job sites actually. So read the job postings very carefully before you are applying for any job. Job posting in the sense, what are all the job postings? What are all included in the job postings? The job description will describe what the employer is seeking in an ideal candidate, because that is very important. You have to read, because that is a detailed description is available in all the job sites for all job postings. The job description will describe what the employer is seeking in an ideal candidate, what kind of candidate, if he is interested, all the information are available in the job description. Reviewing different job postings for similar positions. We don't do this as an exercise actually. One company, one posting, end up. Immediately it is our, you should have thirst of coming across, okay, this bank is asking for this kind of job description for this position. Let us see some other banks. What they are expecting from this particular kind of job description. This is what we are calling as preparation. Reviewing different job postings for similar positions will give you the industry knowledge. This particular job posting will give you the knowledge about that particular organization or a company or an institution. But reviewing different job postings for similar position will give you about the industry, what the industry is required. So don't only read your job postings and your company, read the related job postings and with related companies. That will give you the industry knowledge actually. And then follow how to apply instructions preciously. Research the organization and industry. This is very important. Suppose if you are applying for a leading company, imagine that you are in the front of an interviewer. Imagine that I am your interviewer. You are coming for my, imagine my company name is ABC Limited. After our initial introduction, I am asking you a simple question. Do you know when ABC Limited was established? Because I am very curious to get the correct answer from you, because you are attending for my company's interview. You want to position yourself in my company. So naturally, I am in the need of a valid answer for this particular question actually. But majority of the participants, because as an interview conductor, as an organizer of a lot of interviews, as I am doing a lot of interviews for various institutions and companies, very, 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 very less than 5% of the candidates are coming out with the correct answer, because it shows that they have come across the website very thoroughly with all related informations they have gathered actually. So research the organization and industry, because the answer for this question will give me more pleasure on the candidate. When you are saying I don't know the correct answer for this question, then you know that will give me a kind of irritation to me actually. What kind of this candidate is, what kind of preparation he is having. Like the way I may not able to show the positiveness towards further progress actually. So research the organization and industry, that is very important before applying for any job or any company. Occupational research will give you the big picture information on industry trends, career fields, and the job market. Researching specific employers of interest will bring clarity to the job search process. Please understand, researching specific employers of interest will bring clarity to the job search process. That will give you more clarity. And where you can locate all this information? In the employer's website. You have to visit the employer's website. There you have to read about their news, about the company, contact us, history, their vision, mission. Where all those informations are available, either it will be in the header or bottom of the main page. All those information are available. So before you are before you are applying to any of the company, kindly go through, kindly research about that organization, kindly research some information about that particular industry, and especially about the management, their vision, and what principles they are having, who are all their board of directors, how many board members are available, who are all the managers, how many departments are there. All those information are available in the. So kindly visit, kindly research the organization before you are applying for any job. And final, after making all this preparation, now you have to customize your job search. Whether this job is suit for me, whether this industry can suit for you, that is up to you too. So gather information, review the industry, review the job description, review the company website, and after reviewing all such valid information, Now you can customize your resume. As we discussed in the functional resume, how I discussed, you know, it should be start with your summary of skills in the profile. Actually, it should be with the summary of skills and functional skills, customized 2-minute presentation. How you can present yourself in a small paragraph, customized 2-minute presentation, because this presentation should made up of the it related with the reviews, what you have gathered about that company. You have reviewed something about the industry, career information, job description, company and all, you know, according to matching those information related to you, you have to customized. That is the reason we are saying for every position, you have to have a customized resume and customized interview questions for the employer. You know, these are all the ways you can prepare before you are appearing yourself in front of a interviewer. And for example, now we are I would like to show you a job posting for a company. By the way of seeing this job posting itself, you can able to know what kind of company is that actually. So let us have a small example of reviewing. This is how it looks actually. When you are opening a job posting, first they will start with the overview. Now I'll read this overview. We are currently looking for an account executive professional that enjoys developing and maintaining relationships with the current customers and helping them grow. If you are looking for an opportunity to work with a fast-growing dynamic company that provides accelerated professional opportunities in the thriving online education industry, we would love to hear from you. This is the, they are telling something about what they are in the need actually. What is their want? And now the second stage, they are coming out with job skills and requirements. In this, what is the job skills and requirement for this particular position? What position? Account executive position. In this role, you will promote and generate the use of online educational content and services to institutions of higher learning all over the nation. So such a fantastic position. From an office environment as well as on the road. While providing superior customer service, other responsibilities of this position include, but are not limited to. There are few other responsibilities they are giving, because and they are mentioning that, but are not limited to. There are a lot of other things to be to follow. Coordinate and conduct personal and online meetings to facilitate the implementation of recommendations and best practices. Lies with the partner and internal marketing teams to plan and implement marketing and lead generating objectives. Provide support to the publishing and marketing departments to facilitate implementation of objectives. Maintaining strong relationships with partners and help them identify additional growth opportunities. Lead a partner-focused internal team of professionals whose members report to other departments. So this is the job skills requirements. See, now, by the way of being a fresh graduate, by the way of seeing this information in the job site, what are all the points we are going to take? What are all the points are important for us to provide us a solution provider, solution package? I'll show you in the next slide. The same way, I'll show you in two different colors. We are currently for an account executive professional that enjoys developing and maintaining relationships. So that is the need of that particular company actually. So the company, the employer is asking for an account executive who can developing and maintaining relationships. So we have to, that is a key word we have to take from that particular paragraph. And see, jobs, skills and requirements here. What are all the keywords we can take? Superior customer service. So you have to pack yourself as a solution provider that you can deal good with the customer. You are good in customer services. deepen the relationships, because as they are mentioning very beginning itself, maintaining relationships. So how you are going to provide yourself as a solution provider for maintaining the relationships? Increasing partner presence and offerings of online programs and classes. So they are expecting something related with conducting online programs and classes. What kind of, am I have any experience conducting these kind of, or am I capable of conducting all these things? Those kind of things should take place before applying for this particular job. Coordinate and conduct personal and online meetings, as we discussed earlier. Plan and implement marketing and lead generation objectives. So marketing is also involved in this role. There is no marketing executive. There is no sales executive in the position. The position is account executive. But here, plan and implement marketing and lead generation objectives. So there is a kind of marketing also involved in this particular position. Am I good in marketing? Am I having the ability of making some marketing strategies for success? Identify additional growth opportunities. Lead a partner-focused internal team. So these are all the key words you have to take it from this particular job posting, actually. And applying with yourself. Am I able to produce myself as a solution provider for all these asked needs and wants? Let us see with the candidate's expectation. The same will be available in the job posting. The successful candidate who fills this role will have the following skills and experiences. Might be, as far as you, fresh graduates concerned, you know, there is no need for this experience. So definitely the following skills are need for your successful interview. Minimum education of bachelor's degree plus 2 to 5 years of experience, though an advanced degree is a preferred one. Experience in a position that deals directly with the customers. Frontline dealing with the customer experience is preferred. Previous sales, marketing, relationship management experiences is appreciated. Must be able to effectively communicate and follow up equally with the co-workers and customers. That is related with the teamwork. Must be able to learn and retain vast amounts of client information. It is about our learning process, how we can learn things, how we can maintain things. Experience in a team-based environment is preferred. Experience in higher education is a bonus. Experience using client resource management software is preferred, actually. So these are all the expectations from the employer. From this, what are all the keywords we can take it? The words in red, bachelor's degree plus 2 to 5 years of experience, you have to take. Whether am I having a bachelor? Yes, I'm having bachelor degree. 2 to 5 years of experience? No, I'm a fresh graduate. I can apply for this. Advanced degree is preferred. You can take this particular word. Yes, I'm having an advanced degree. So that is an additional advantage for me. Yes. Deals directly with the customers, frontline. So I have to deal my customers as a frontline. I have to go and meet the customers on road and off road. Previous sales, marketing, or relationship management. Being a fresher, you should not say that I'm a fresher. I'm not having any sales, marketing, or relationship management. You are having a lot of opportunities while doing your graduations on to show your relationship management examples. A lot of things happened in your college days, how you took those things, how you engaged yourself, how you have participated, how you are conducted. Must be able to effectively communicate. So you have to show that you are an effectively communicable person. Learn and retain vast amounts of client information, team-based environment, higher education, client resource management. So these are all the keywords you can take it from this particular. Though, by the way of seeing a job posting, job description, job profile, employer details, and your candidate skills and knowledge, experiences. So this, after taking all those keywords, now you have to form the resume headings. Because this company is asking marketing, sir, then you have to show yourself that you are strong in marketing. You are interested in marketing. You are having ideas in marketing. You are having a lot of creativity in marketing. You are having a lot of problems related to marketing activities. That's how you have to. Functional skills. As we discussed about the functional resume, the skills should be in the assess subheadings. What are all the subheadings you can position for this particular opportunity? Customer relationship management, marketing and sales, curriculum development, secondary education experience, information technology experience, as they are asking for CRM and all, management and leadership experience, because you have to deal with the team and working with the organization, your communication, your project development, all those things you can have it in the as a subheadings of your resume. And finally, other section headings can be your accomplishments. What are all the successful accomplishments you have made during your graduation or other experience, professional development, profile, all those things. And how to customize the interview, my dear participants? That is 2 minute presentation. Because in the previous stage, I'll show you that. See, this overview, the first paragraph, this is their 2 minutes presentation. Like the way you have to present yourself. Minutes presentation, background in your resume, background in higher education, what are all the projects you have completed related with the e-learning, since this company is asking for online solutions, the e-learning project completed that highlights the skills and assets bringing to the company, sales and relationship management examples, if anything, if you are having personal experience with e-learning in own education, customer service success stories, if anything you are having, you can highlight all those things in your 2 minute presentation. Acknowledge how organization's mission fits with your experience and interest. This is how you have to, because I am having that much of patience to watch, because I'm not going to watch your entire resume. The first few lines, that is enough for me to identify who you are. So 2 minutes presentation is very, very important. Customize your presentation according to the needs. And we are coming to the last portion of preparation. A lot of preparation is there, actually. We have limited, because I don't want to take you to the much elaborate preparation level. So the basic and important ideas of preparation that we have shared. So preparation is the key to success, my dear participants. In preparation, first review your own skills. Own skills review, how we can review your own skills. That too we have already discussed in the SWOT analysis. Making the SWOT analysis will helpful to you to review your own skills. Identify your strengths, identifying your weaknesses. Review your own skills, experiences, and qualities. Check the CV, check your resume. Anticipate questions and identify relevant examples. You have to anticipate the questions, actually, because there are some basic questions. Today I'm going to show you some, I'm having some questions. I have shortlisted some questions for you. There are hundreds of questions available in the list, actually, but today I have shortlisted with a few questions. I'll share those questions with you after this. Anticipate questions, identify relevant examples, prepare key selling points, and research the organization. Nothing, as I told you in the beginning, research the organization's websites, reports, articles, company literature, contacts with the knowledge of organization or sector. Suppose if you are having an interview with a bank, you may have a lot of friends, relations working for bank, for very other bank. You can take their knowledge also, or you can speak to your professors, and you can take the somebody's mentorship to know something more about that particular sector or particular organization. Relevant articles in the press, personal visit, or telephone call. Even you can make telephones and asking for your clarifications. Research job and occupational area, especially as we discussed earlier, read the job description and read the current issues, prepare your questions. And finally, practice yourself. Practice makes a man perfect. As we discussed in the first 30 seconds, watch the body language. Whose body language? Your body language. First watch your body language, then we supposed to watch the interviewer's body language also. Watch the body language. Watch the body language means first impression is very, very powerful. As we discussed earlier, I am having very limited time. First 30 seconds, first 40 seconds are enough for me to justify about the candidate. So, dress well, groom yourself properly, wear well-ironed shirts, don't go with the wrinkled shirts, don't go with loose fits and all. The black shoes are perfect for interviews. Tuck in, good belt, wearing tie, well-shaved. So these are all the few identification for giving us a kind of good impression, actually. So that first impression is very powerful. Don't forget, allow time to relax. As we said, dress appropriately, because your dressings, in my first 30 seconds, I'm going to very much watchful on your dressings, your hairstyle, your grooming style, everything, actually. Entrance, introductions, and handshakes. How you are opening the door, how you are asking for the excuse, may I come in or something like that, how you are waiting for the answer, because very few, you know, I used to watch many people, you know, they'll be just knocking the door, opening the, they'll be straight away, they are coming inside the room. They are not asking for the reply from the people inside the chamber, actually. May I come in? Straight away come in. Taking. That is not the proper way. When you are asking for a question, may I come in? Then you should wait for the answer to come. So after taking the answer, you should get inside. Introduction of yourself. You can give a firm handshake, having an eye contact, smile, be aware of your own movements in the sense how you are pulling the chair, how you are sitting, how you are keeping your files in the table, lot of own movements. Watch body language of the interviewer. Watching his body language is also very important, because a few interviewers, they may be playful. Few interviewers, they may be very serious. Few interviewers, they may be very professional. Few interviewers, there may be very common, very normal, actually. A lot of body languages. We can able to identify the body language. By the way of watching the body language itself, we can able to identify the need of the interviewer. So watch the body language of yourself as well as the interviewer. Excuse me. Now we are entering into the chapter of interview. What do you mean by interview? Interview, nothing but there is a meeting between two people with a particular objective. The employer is having an objective. The employee who is going, the participant, the interview, he is also having some objective to meet, actually. Employer's objective is to find the best person for the job, nothing else. What might be the employer's objective? The employer's objective is to find the best person for the job, not the normal person for the job. Best person. He wants the best among all participants. So, to take the best performer, the employer reviews candidate's experience and abilities. He is not going to review your graduation certificate. Please understand. That is the reason in my earlier sessions, I was told that your graduation certificate can take you to the interview, but there is no guarantee of providing you the job. Whereas your skills, your experiences, and your abilities can definitely take you to the career success. So the employer is in the need of finding the best person for the job. What do you mean by best person? As we discussed IQ and EQ. Yesterday we have discussed, you know. So the mixture of IQ and EQ is considered to be the best personality. So the employer reviews the candidate's experiences and abilities. So here, how he can review? By the way of asking few questions. Can you do the job? If he is asking this question, can you do the job? we will be answering something. With that answer, he can able to understand our skills, ability and qualifications. Will you do the job? Because you are applying for a marketing position. Now he is saying it's for accountant. Will you do the job? He is asking. He wants to know about our interest, our attitude and our motivation towards change actually. And how will you fit into the organization? Why should I give this job to you? He wants to check your personality, your strengths. He wants to check about your strengths. So these kind of questions. Why the interviewer is asking a kind of questions to the interview candidate, you know? He wants to check your skills, abilities, qualification, interest, attitude, motivation, personality. All those things we are saying as a soft skills. And he is asking all these questions to check that whether this particular candidate is a best person or not. And ourselves, what we are doing, impress employer and assess position and on offer. What does this position offer to me? How does it fit with my career plans? Because we already discussed about your career plan, career goal, short-term goal, long-term goal. Because you know, you are having your own career plan. How this position can fit with your career plan? If you are mixing both these, congratulations, my dear participants. You have passed the first hurdle. You must prove that you are the most suitable candidate for this position. And what are all the typical questions to be asked in the interviews? As I told, there are some questions. Why they are asking these questions? That is very important. It seems sometimes why this particular interviewer is asking me this kind of silly questions, which is not related to my job or which is not related to. Tell me about yourself. What is the need of asking this question? Tell me something about yourself or bring me up to date with your resume or CV. Why did you choose that particular degree program? Suppose a commerce graduate. I'm asking why you choose commerce as your degree program. And what experience have you had that is relevant to this post? Are you having any experiences related to this job position? And what would you consider your major achievements up to date? But these are all the basic questions. How you are answering to these questions will show who you are to me actually. And about the job, if I am coming, you know, what interest you about this job? For example, the job which you have, accounts executive or accounts manager. What interest you about this job? What do you know about this organization, this ABC Limited? What do you know about this ABC Limited? What other options are you considering? Suppose if I am not giving you this job, what are all the other options you are having to consider? How do you see your career developing in next 5 years? For answering this question, you should have your short-term goals, clear your short-term goals as well as your long-term goals. If you are head of the department, what would be your priorities? All basic questions to know something, to check something about your job knowledge. And they may be asking you for general knowledge questions also. And some other questions, you know, I'd like to share with you, my dear. I'm having in the list. See, there are another question. What are your strengths? When they are asking for this question, what are your strengths? Or tell me about yourself, what you are seeing in the screen actually. Why this question being asked to you? This question serves as a yardstick for evaluating your aptitude for the vacancy. Your response to these questions will helpful to the interviewer understanding your strengths align with the company's requirement. The purpose of asking this question is nothing but to identify your strengths, which means you should have a lot of strengths. Strengths related with what? As we discussed, personality strength, professional strength, internal strength, external strengths, a lot of personality related strengths we have discussed early. You have to show the strengths. And what are all the strengths you have gained by the way of doing your SWOT analysis? That are all the strengths you have to expose. So why they are asking this question is to know what is your strength actually. And when they are asking about what are all your weaknesses? Again, a typical question. I used to ask in many of my interviews, what are all your weaknesses? You think yourself, if somebody is asking this question to you, what are all the things you are having in your mind to say something about your weaknesses? Little difficult to answer for this question. And why they are asking this question to us? Because you know very well, your weaknesses will definitely not going to helpful for you as well as for me. Then why I am asking this particular question? Why I am asking this question is, recruiters prefer, interviewers prefer hiring professionals that are always ready to learn new aspects. Suppose what our SWOT analysis explained. I am having three weaknesses and six strengths means when I am conducting for the next month, I should have only two weaknesses and seven strengths I should have, which means I should change myself. I start practicing something for reducing my weaknesses. So I am adopting a new change for making a better strength actually. So that is the reason the recruiters prefer hiring professionals that are always ready to learn new aspects and improve their. I am having this as my weakness. Yes, I am accepting this as my weakness, but I am having the courage of making my weakness into strength. That is the reason this question was asked. How you can answer to this question? Tell me something about your weaknesses. You know, I used to, many students in our country, they used to ask, sir, how can we answer for this question, sir? No, I believe I have issues with telling a no to people. Actually speaking, that is a weakness of, personally, that is a weakness of mine. Saying no to people. Many of the human are having this as our biggest weakness actually. Saying no to the people, telling no to the people. Hence, when my supervisors give me work, even though I already have my hands full, I tend to take up extra projects, which has affected my efficiency a few times. When this happened, I quickly analyzed the situation and made efforts the next time to take on few projects. Saying no. I don't know how to say no, sir. That is my weakness. I am a talkative personality. That is my weakness. Or like the way you have to produce yourself by the way of asking these kind of questions. And let us say, I'm having a lot of questions actually, I will tell you. Why do you want to leave your current company? Suppose if you are applying with the kind of experience, if you want to shift over your job, this question is again a typical question. They want to check your credibility with your existing company. Don't say negative feedback about your previous company. Suppose if you are working for one college. Oh, for example, I'm a professor. I'm working for one college. Now I'm applying for another college for some different opinion, you know, for different options, for different possibility. And that institution is asking why you are leaving that particular institution. I have to say something related with my benefits. I should not say any negative feedback about that institution. That institution is not good, so I am leaving my job. Naturally, what is of my what this institution will feel? One day you will speak like this about this institution. So don't speak negatively when they are asking about switch over and all. And I'm looking for any good questions actually. Are you willing to relocate? Because as far as Malawi is concerned, I think it is a typical thing to get job in your own place. So probably you may have the relocation actually. This question should be well answered. Typical questions. Are you willing to travel? Yes. Tell me about an accomplishment you are most proud of. You should have some accomplishments to say, to share in your interview panel actually. That is the reason in the previous sessions I was asking four important questions. Tell me about yourself. Why you choose this as your degree program? And what are all the additional qualities and qualifications you have gained during your graduation? What are all the additional qualifications you have gained during your graduation? Well, what are all the additional accomplishments you did during your graduation? You have to answer. What is your dream job? If you are having a career goal related with your career, definitely you will be having answer for this question. What is your dream job? How did you hear about this position? What would you accomplish in the first 30, 60, 90 days in the job? Where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? Describe yourself. Tell me how you handled a difficult situation. Tell me how you handled a difficult situation. These are all some important typical questions the interviewer may ask you. Why should I hire you? Why should I hire you? Again, a typical question. Why he is asking this question? You said, why should I hire you? The interviewer wants you to convince him. The interviewer wants him to convince by you. Why you are the perfect fit for the job? This question seeks to squeeze out valuable information about the personality of the candidate applying for the position. How you can answer for this? Why should I hire you? Why should I give this job to you? How you can, and because this is an important question, you know, because many interviewers will ask you for this question. So I can give a model answer also for this. So convince the interviewer by telling him about your ability to carry out quality of work and noteworthy outcomes. Your exceptional teamwork aptitude, which will make the organization to the next level. Your multidisciplinary and unique skills make you the perfect applicant for the job. Give examples for all the above points mentioned. Don't forget to give examples. I'll tell you later actually. Also, talk about the benefits of recruiting you and how it would be an unregrettable decision of the company. So use your strengths, use your accomplishments to show that you are the perfect fit to the organization. So these are all the typical questions, some kind of typical questions you'll be asked in the interviews. Get ready. That is the reason we are saying preparation, preparation, preparation. These kind of typical questions. These typical questions and your answers are the key portions by the way of selecting yourself. Please understand how you are answering these typical questions are the key points on selecting yourself. So prepare yourself for these typical questions with your perfect answers, with your matching abilities. And other types of questions will be also asked, if type of questions. If you are having no experience, how you are likely to respond to the situation? How exactly did you deal with the situation? How did you know it worked? How did you feel about the outcome? Could you have handled it differently? All those kind of questions used to ask to the freshers actually, probing questions. We used to call that as a probing question. So how you can answer this kind of probing questions? Now we are coming to the, I'll tell you how we have to answer to these kind of probing questions actually. Now we are coming to the interviews, second level, competency-based interviews. As you know very well about knowledge-based interviews, the more things they will be keen on testing your IQ. And competency-based interviews, the more things the interviewers keen on checking your EQs actually. See, understand, company identifies key skills required for the job. Because many of the jobs are having wanted any graduate, even if it is an engineering graduate, arts graduate, science graduate, that is none of their prime. They want skilled graduates. They want to graduate with enriched with a lot of skills. So competency-based interviews usually identifies the key skills required for a job during the interviews. They design questions to elicit evidence of skills. They design all these questions, what you have discussed is related to evidence of your skills actually. So they design questions for the elicit to evidence of your skills actually. Emphasis on past behavior as predictor of success. They want to check your teamwork. They want to check your communication skills. They want to check your interpersonal skills. They want to check how responsibility, what kind of responsible person you are, and what kind of problem solving techniques about yourself. All those things they want to check. Because what do you mean by competency? These are all the competency. Your communication is a competency. Working on teams is your competency. Your interpersonal skills and interpersonal relationships are your competency. Taking responsibility is your competency. Problem solving skills are your competency. All those things we have discussed in our earlier workshop actually. In the current workshop actually. So if you are having time, if you watch all our programs from the beginning, definitely you are having answer for all these competency levels actually. How to increase all these competency within yourself. So competency-based interviews, they used to ask you questions to check whether you people are having all these kind of important competencies which can which are a need for your career success. So how you can prepare for the competency interview? Identify the competencies required for a job. Please review the job description or ask for the information, as we discussed many times about the job description. Let us move to the next question, next level. Define each competency in behavioral terms. Identify your past experience to illustrate how you demonstrated that behavior. Prepare examples for each competency. Don't say that I am having time management as a competency. Don't say I'm having teamwork as a competency. You have to come out with real time examples actually. Why I'm saying punctuality is again a key thing because people love people with punctuality actually. So prepare examples for each competency. Practice talking about your experiences. Relate those examples with your experiences actually. Try to give a complete answer called STAR. The STAR is for four main things. S stands for situations. What kind of situations? And what is the T stands for task. What task I was. A stands for action. What action I take. And R stands for result. What is the situation? What task I take. And what action I did. And what results I have gained. This is called STAR type of answers. So when they are coming out, when they are asking for your competency related questions, your answer should be a STAR type of answer. For example, give me an example of a problem you encountered. How did you approach it? What was the outcome? This is how the question will be made, and the response from your side will be describe the situation. That is the meaning of S. Situation. Describe the situation. Explain the task or problem that arose. And what action did you take? And what was the result or outcome from the particular action? Through that particular action. And what did you learn from this experience? So this is how you have to respond. People love, the interviewers will love you, and definitely they will have a soft corner on you. And that will take you to the lead. Understand this, employers need communication, teamwork, leadership, initiative, customer care, information technology, and some kind of commercial awareness. For that, you have to evidence that being a fresher, I put all those information. Presentation to class, Example from cooperative, class representation, committee fundraising for charity, working in Superqueen, designed website, business pages, all those things you can consider, you can say that as an evidence of fulfilling the needs of the employer. Ensure that before your answer, listen carefully. If you are not clarified with the question, you ask for the clarification. Listen carefully and seek clarification. Illustrate answers with the real examples, as we discussed, star type of answers. Be positive, constructive criticism. Keep answers specific and succinct. Don't give elaborate answers, because I'm not having passion enough to listen the elaborate answers. So keep your answers specific and succinct. Take time to respond, but don't take much time to respond. Be alert to interviewer's body language. Speak clearly, smile, and show enthusiasm, because sharing enthusiasm is the key for success in the interview. The interviewers may expect a maximum enthusiasm from their participants, actually. So know what you want to say and find the opportunity. That's how you have to develop your answers before presenting. Qualities employers seek. The employers are in the need of a kind of qualities. What kind of qualities? A good all-round intelligence. Prove that you are all-round, you are having all-round intelligence. Enthusiasm. Share your enthusiasm. Commitment and motivation. Good communication skills. Teamwork ability. Ability to solving problems. Capacity to work hard. Initiative and self-reliance. Balanced personality. Managing stress and all. So these are all the expectation of the employers. And competencies. What kind of competencies they are expecting from their team? Adaptability, integrity, which means, what is the purpose of showing this? You have to show in your resume, and you have to present yourself during your presentation, that you are a person with adaptability, you are a person with the integrity, with innovation, teamwork, initiative, driven for results, know the business, open exchange of information, makes difficult decisions. All those competencies I am having, you have to expose yourself in that particular limited time. That is the reason I am showing this. This is their expectation, and you have to show this is these are all the qualities as your prime qualities. And you may ask questions in the interview. No, there is no hesitation. You may think, how come I can ask? You are having all freedom to ask questions. What are all the related questions you can ask? You can ask questions related with the training programs. What kind of training programs that employer is going to offer for you to do your betterment in your career journey? Career development opportunities. I am joining as accounts executive. And what kind of promotion, what kind of upcoming benefits am I having in my career journey? Types of projects and responsibilities, reporting structure, to whom I have to report, performance appraisal, whether this company is having performance appraisal system, because almost all the companies are having performance appraisal system, as we discussed many times in our previous stages, profile of staff, questions about topics raised in the interview, and what happens next, what I have to do, sir, am I waiting for, how much time I have to wait, am I get a reply through email or over phone, or a lot of questions you can ask from your side to make the interview most of yourself. And this is how the marking sheet will be generally. Maximum marks will be 100. I am having this as my grade sheet, actually. When I am conducting interviews for various companies, I used to have this as my grading sheet, actually. For communication skill, I am having 30%. For your problem solving skill, I am having 20%. Your team fitness, I will be having 20%. And your relevant experiences, I'll be giving 20%. And your project management, I'll be giving 10%. This is how, see where your graduation marks. This is competency based. So I am giving all 100 marks for your competencies only. Maybe 5 or 10 marks percentage for your graduation accomplishments, actually. So this is my interview marking sheet. And please understand, what are all the things creates a bad impression? No need to explain much about this. Poor personal appearance, as I told, nowadays, you know, the students are coming with trimmed beard, modern shirts, without tucking, casual shoes, formal shirts, loose shirts and loose pants. They are saying that as a modern. But even though it is modern, when the time of your interview, your appearance should be perfect. So go to the interview, appear the interview with the professional appearance. Don't go with your freaky appearance. So that will give you a poor personal appearance. Negative attitude. Don't use excuses. Time management. Punctuality. Say something about positiveness. Lack of interest and enthusiasm. Be enthusiastic till your interview over. Lack of preparation. You should prepare well, as we discussed much things about the preparation. Poor knowledge of role, as we discussed earlier, job role. You should study and apply yourself with that role. Failure to give concrete examples of skills, as we discussed earlier, or explain all your skills with real-time examples. Overemphasis on money and rewards. Being a fresher, that is another typical question. What is your salary expectation? What you are expecting from us, you know? Being a fresher, you should not ask for, this is my expectation. Majority companies will provide you a decent package only. Actually, nowadays, there is no companies are providing such a low package, and the kind of companies are no more, actually. So being a fresher, how you can answer, you know, up to the company's wish. I know I'm going to work for a good company. This company will have definitely a decent package. I think I can fit into that package. That's how you can answer. Because if you're asking for specified money, you know, that shows that you are a money-minded personality. You can ask a kind of monetary benefits once you are having sufficient experience. So after completing 2-3 years of your experience, now you are going for a job change, company change. That time, you can expect you can ask for your expectations. Lack of career plan. So all those things will create a kind of bad impression. An interviewer can easily able to identify you are having these as a bad. These are all the qualities you are having. So after the interview, review your own performance. What went well and what went bad? Because you are not going to attend only one interview. Interview is a process. So review your own performance after all the interviews you have attended. What went well and what went badly? What you wish to, what you wished and what you had said. Prepare for the next stage. There might be an invitation to the second and final round of interviews that might be happened in the assessment centers, psychometric testing, panel interview, a lot of interview, other types of interview also available. You may ask for the second interview, you may ask for the final interview with a different type of environment. And suppose if you are not selected, the rejection letter will reach you. And what about the telephone interviews? Nowadays, before meeting any person, any personality, any participant in person, before physical meeting, almost all the companies are conducting telephone interviews. For telephone interviews, prepare as thoroughly as for real interview. Don't take lightly as a telephone interview. Prepare as thoroughly as for real interview. If you did well in the telephone interview, then only we'll be having a chance of meeting for the second level interview. Select comfortable, private, and quiet place. Advise a re-answering phone, hands-free phone. Have a copy of CV and company-related information in your hand. Have pen and paper at hand. Sometimes you need to take some information shared by the... He maybe tell something. You should have pen, paper at your hand. Prepare for usual interview questions. Don't take telephone interviews lightly, and don't feel that because of telephone interviews, the interviewer may have a limited questions. Prepare for usual interview questions. Practice on phone. Record your answers. Nowadays, all your phones are having recording options. You can record your answers. For example, you yourself ask what are all your strengths, and you try record your answer. You'll be having a lot of things to change, actually, if you start doing this recording exercises. Try standing. Don't sit in a leisure position. And whenever you are having an opportunity, try standing and speaking. That will give more comfort and enthusiasm. Smile and use gestures. Now you see, now I'm speaking. I'm using my hands. Watching here, there. Smile and use gestures. Avoid monotones and be yourself. Don't imitate. Be yourself. And other types of interviews, what you have discussed, you know. Rotating interviews. Some places, the HR will conduct the first level. Next, you will take him to the finance head will conduct the interview. And next, the chairman of the company, CEO, will conduct the final interview. That is called rotating interview. Like one-to-one with different interviewers. First HR, then the department head, then the CEO. Rotating interviews. And there are other interviews called group interviews. Group interview means in the panel, there are 6 to 8 candidates. Now I'm speaking about the panel. I have changed the group interviews for the, because suppose as I told you as an example, you know, I want to select 10 candidates. Imagine I made a advertisement and there is a walk-in date. I am seeing there are 250 candidates appearing in front of me for this 10 position. What I have to do? You just imagine. Can I do one-to-one interview? For me, it takes minimum 1.5 days to complete. Then what I'll do? Then I'll have a group exercise, group interviews actually. I can do 6 to 8 or 8 to 10 candidates. Come, they joined us a group. I'll give them a topic. I'll ask them to speak. Group observed while discussing topic. That is called group discussion. Be aware of group interaction. In that group discussion, I can able to identify one or two best personalities actually. Who is initiating, who is having relevant information related to the topic, and who is showing more enthusiasm. Now, from that group of 8 to 10, I can easily shortlist 2 within 5 minutes. Like the way, if I'm conducting 10-20 group discussions, within 2 hours, I can able to shortlist 20 candidates. From that 20 candidates, I can have a one-to-one discussion and I can easily choose 10 candidates. That is called group interviews. And panel interviews, as I told you, 2 to 5 interviewers or as many, depends upon the company. When I was attending in an interview in the year 2009 for a company called India Infoline, the first preliminary interview was took place in my hometown actually. Then they asked me to come to a place called Bangalore, that is 500 kilometers away from my hometown actually. I visited that place and there are 11 members in the panel actually. 11 members, 11 department heads. No, 11 members from 5 departments actually for shortlisting. That is called a panel interviews. What you have to do, you know, panel interviews. So you have to give shake hands to almost all the panel members while answering your answers, you know. You have to have the eye contact with all the team members, all the panel members. And you have to smile with all the panel members. And you can expect any questions from any of the panel members. That's called a panel interview. Try to identify different roles. Why the reason? One panel member from finance department, one panel member from HR department, one panel member from sales department. Everybody will come out, everybody will shoot out with some kind of questions to you. Why? They want to understand what kind of different responsibilities, different roles, different ideas you are having. Respond to interviewer, including others, through eye contact may involve presentation. These are all the other types of interviews. Rotating interviews, group interviews, panel interviews. So get ready to face any kind of interviews in your life. And next is assessment centers. What is assessment centers? Assessment centers are centers like company premises or neutral venue. Assessment centers may be available in company or maybe in a neutral venue. It includes social or informal events. Sometimes, you know, they used to conduct, in our country, people used to conduct interviews in the hotels, actually. Big hotels, star category hotels, big suits. Those places are considered as assessment centers. That includes social or informal events, meeting with recent graduates or managers, activities included in assessment centers, group discussion, practical task and exercises, report writing exercises, oral presentation, psychometric assessments, interviews. Almost all kind of interview process will took place in the assessment centers. Simulates real working environment. You can feel as a real working environment in the assessment center. It gives you that kind of comfort that you are in a working real time working environment. That is called assessment center. And psychometric tests related with the aptitude. There are certain jobs they want your aptitude. You have to practice in your day-to-day career travel. Aptitude tests measure skills relevant to position, your verbal comprehension, your numerical reasoning, your diagrammatic reasoning, watch timing, complete as many as possible. So these are all related with your aptitude test. All those aptitude tests will took place in psychometric test centers, actually. And your personality questionnaires, look at personality style, no right or wrong answer. There are some questions. There is no right answer. There is no wrong answer. Be spontaneous. Don't try to second guess. Test include built-in checks. Employers may be looking for different personality profiles. Actually, it was a very famous question. I think you are aware of that. During an interview, this question was asked to the participant, actually. You are driving a car in a stormy night, in a forest road, midnight. You are having only one position, one seat in your car. You are driving a car. By the way, you are seeing a bus stop. There, three people are standing. One is an old lady. She is about to die. She is in the need of a hospital care, a kind of lady. She is standing. And you are seeing another, the second personality is your friend, actually. He once saved your life, actually. You once saved your life in a very critical situation. And this is the right time for you to help him, actually. He's also standing over there. And the third personality is a beautiful lady, a gorgeous lady, who is your dream girl. Three persons are standing in the bus shed, actually. You are having one place, stormy night. And what you are going to do? That is a question asked to the participants, actually. You are having one seat, stormy night, forest road. Three persons are standing in the bus stop. One is an old lady about to die. Another one, your close friend who had helped you a lot in your previous problems. And third one is your dream girl. And what you are going to do? People are coming out with a lot of answer, but there is one answer for shortlisted. That answer is, one participant said, I will get down from my car. I will give the car to my friend. I will take the old lady into my car. I will suggest my friend to put her in the hospital. I'll be staying in the bus stop with my girlfriend, with my dream girl. And that answer was shortlisted as the best answer. So how your presence of mind is, you are applying your presence of mind for this kind of questions, actually, psychometric tests. So now we are going to the conclusion before we are finalizing our session. Final thought. Though each person has specific needs, drives, aspirations, and capabilities at varying degrees of intensity, people's basic needs are the same. psychological needs. Why you are going for a job? Why you are attending interview? We are having some psychological needs. We want to fulfill that psychological needs. What psychological needs? Basic physical needs like the ability to acquire food, shelter, clothing, and other basics to survive. And safety needs. Psychological needs is food, shelter, cloth, and other basic things. Safety needs. What do you want to fulfill your safety needs? A safe and non-threatening working environment, job security, safe equipment, and insulation. Safety needs. And we are in the need of social also. Social needs. Contacts and friendship with the fellow employees, social activities and opportunities. These are all the need of any human actually. Ego needs. We are having ego needs also. Recognition. We want recognition. Acknowledgement. We want acknowledgement and we want rewards. Self-actualization needs. Realizing one's dreams and potential. Reaching the heights of one's gifts and talents. Self-actualization and recognition. It is only when these needs are met that employees are morally, emotionally, and even physically ready to satisfy the needs of the employer and the customers. If the needs are not met, what will happen? So the prime, why we are going for an interview, why we want to take a job, why we want to have a career, is to fulfill all those needs what we have discussed. And most employees, most graduates, most people are in the need of why they are going for employment, because they want to have in wages, they want to save money, have insurance coverage, acquire friends at work, win recognition, be acknowledged and rewarded, able to advance in life and career, have opportunities for self-development, improving their skills, knowledge and know-how, demonstrate and use special gifts and abilities, realize their ideas. Like the way the employer is also responding. The employer responds to those who needs by offering and providing. You are having your own needs, the 10-11 needs we have seen earlier. And now the employer responds. How he is responding you with the way of employment, adequate pay, assistance to workers for their special needs, job security, clear company policies, clear and organized work procedures, a stable, just and fair work environment, a safe environment, medical coverage, an atmosphere of teamwork and cooperation, social activities, reward and recognition programs, incentive programs, open lines of communication, systematic feedback, training and development, opportunities for promotion, company and business information, information on customer feedback, sharing of company goals and objectives, information on the market situation and industry, future expectations, plans for future, guidance and mentoring, all those things the employers are providing to fulfill your expectations. You are having some expectation as an employee. We are having some kind of expectation as an employer. He is responding with the kind of solutions to fulfill our expectation. So don't forget, career or employment is not a normal thing. It's an important event actually. In addition to needs and drives, employees have expectation from their employer. That are all their needs. Not only their needs. Employees have some more expectations from their employer. What are all their expectations? A knowledgeable, experienced, expert employer. An employee don't want to engage himself with a knowledgeless and unexperienced and expertless employer. He want a knowledgeable and experienced and expert employer. Clear and fair policies, procedures, and employment practices. That is every employee's expectation. The company should have clear and fair policies. It should have clear and procedures, good employment practices, business integrity. There is no business integrity. That is the reason we have seen negative working environments where a company is failing on this expectation. That company, that organization is considered as negative working environment actually. So the employees are expecting knowledgeable, experienced employer, clear and fair policies, procedures, business integrity, clear job descriptions, two-way communication. It should not be one-way communication, two-way communication, which means good relationship, interpersonal relationship. They are expecting effective management and supervision, positive discipline, good company reputation, good customer relations and company fittest of the survival, opportunities for personal growth, company growth, a share in the company's success, which means bonus, other benefits. Sorry. Employees care beyond the salary. Definitely, this is the truth. Employees care beyond the salary. They care to know to whom they entrust their fate, reputation, and security. They consider their work as a major factor that shapes their lives and the lives of those dear to them. Because employees are more care about the company, about the reputation, because they are working to take care of their dear and near and their family actually. Once they feel confident that the employer and their place of work is what they wished for and expected, they are ready to contribute above and beyond the call of duty. If they are satisfied with their expectation and the fulfillment, they will be doing the extremely good things to the company. Naturally, the company will grow to the next extent. Most of these needs, expectations, and aspirations are unexpressed. It is up to the employer to develop a good system of company communications, employee relations, training and development that will lead to an environment with openness, environment with cooperation, environment with the teamwork, and environment with motivation. So these are all the inputs an employer has to provide for making the employee in a comfort zone for making their company progressing towards a great success. I think we came to the end of the program actually. Now I'm ready to answer for your questions related with the interviews actually. Now you can shoot out your questions, my dear participants, related to the interview successions. Now only I can able to see the chat box. You can shoot out your questions. We can conduct interviews in these ways. Step one, written test. Yes. Group discussion, those who passed in the written test. Yes. Finally, personal interview, those who performed well in the group discussion. Yes, that is what R.A.K. Rubin sir chat in the chat box is absolutely correct. But you know, nowadays, you know, people are not having that much passion to conduct the written test and all, because now we are all running behind the technology, you know. So very few companies are doing this written test. Instead, they are having this group discussion practice actually. Straight away, they are having group discussion and they'll take their prospective candidates from the group discussion. What happens if one has a great verbal comprehension and not numerical reasoning? Do they fail in the interview? Again, Shishali madam, I would like to say, I can't say that he is a failure, but the career what he choose is very important actually. As I discussed in the beginning, knowledge-based career is there, and the competency-based career is there. What kind of job he is choosing? Suppose if he is having great verbal comprehension, there is no need for him to engage himself as a programmer, because he is not having numerical reasoning. He cannot be a successful programmer. He cannot be a successful software professional. Whereas If he is having a great verbal as his greatest quality, he can choose a sales job. He can choose a marketing job. He can choose job where he can apply his verbal communication, resource job, training job, professor, teaching job, all those job or related job for this particular personality. So choosing a career is very important. That's what I told, you know, after identifying your strength and weaknesses, applying your strength towards the job description, towards the company's expectation, then you move yourself. Don't apply yourself to all the job portals, all the job postings. Then it will be a waste of your time and the employer's time. What makes someone to fail in interview? What makes some people failure in the interview? You know, poor preparation, lack of knowledge, not identifying their competencies, commitment, self-motivation, all those things only, nothing else. Because I can say if you are good enough in your emotional intelligence, you can do very good in the interviews. We can conduct interviews in this. No, group discussion. No, I'll see. Finally, personal interview. Any other? What makes someone to fail in interviews is lack of preparation. Again, we can say lack of preparation. Not understanding the expectation. Not understanding his own competencies. That are all the reasons. I understand. Thank you. Anybody else want to ask? Feedback form closed for response, sir. Yes, Mr. Rajkumar, sir. I think we are having only one today. We are on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Another 3 days only we are having. Last 3 days. Tomorrow we'll be speaking about leadership management. Tomorrow, day after tomorrow, we are going to speak something about self-esteem and self-trust. Actually, both are again related with your competencies. And the final day, review day, you can ask whatever the topics we have discussed. You can ask all your doubts and you can share your feedback also on that particular day. That is Friday. Also, that is our last day of our progressing webinar. So thank you very much for today's participants. I hope I can cover some of the important topics of making the most of your interviews. With this, I will wind up. If you are having any questions, you can shoot out that questions. Mr. Rajkumar sir will definitely take out the questions and he will definitely find the answers and he will reply you with the answers. With this, thank you very much from my side. I leave the session to Mr. Rajkumar sir.
Mr. Antony sir.
Yes.
We have received some questions from the participants.
Yes.
The first question, what happens if one has great verbal comparisons, comprehensions and non-numerical reasoning? Do they fail the interview?
This question was already answered, sir, just before. I think you have missed. I have seen it directly and I have already answered. And there is a new question I am seeing in the chat box. Yes. Why interviews are important? Because it is a place where you can share two people's, because we discussed earlier, employers are in the need and want, because they want solution for the problem. They are having some challenges to fulfill actually. They want to fulfill that challenges with the help of some kind of abilities only, not with the normal people. They want some able people to fulfill their challenges. That is their expectation. That is their need. And here, there are employees. What is their expectation? They want to have a job. They want to make some money to run their family. They are having some kind of skills. My skills, am I matching my skills with that employer's need actually? To know about their expectation as well as my skills matching. How I am matching my skills and abilities towards the expectation of the employer. Where there is one place where we can match your skills according to the need of. That place is called interview. So interview is an important place. You are, no, nobody can escape from that particular interview process. If you want to have a strong career choice, career success, you should have interview in your lifetime. Suppose if you can say, I can become an entrepreneur, sir. This particular point I have missed actually. With the help of this question, I think I can answer that also. Sir, for example, I don't want to engage myself as an employer. I want to engage myself as an entrepreneur, or I want to engage myself as a self-employer. Then what way the interview makes a sense? You know, if you want to become an entrepreneur also, you are having your idea. You want others to, go through with your idea, which means you have to pitch yourself. You have to pitch your idea. You have to pitch your strategies to other people. The other people, in the sense, the investors, the incubators, the mentors, the customers, the clients, the competitors, all those people have to accept your idea. When they can accept your idea, you have to present yourself properly. If you are having the presentation capability of presenting who you are and what is your project and what are all the benefits and features of your project, then only the third party will accept your ideas and your project. If you are an employee, if you are taking the journey in employment, if you are taking the journey as an entrepreneur, either way, presenting yourself is playing the crucial role. For employment journey, you'll be having interviews, and for this entrepreneurial journey, we are having some other terminologies that we will discuss in the next session, upcoming sessions. So interviews are important to show who you are to the employer. Interviews are important to know whom they are selecting to the, as far as the employer's point of view.
Thank you, Mr. Anthony. The more information on the successful interviews, the participants, it's very useful for you, for your career. Thank you so much. Any questions from the participant side? Any questions? If you have any questions, just raise your questions in the chat box. Our resource person is ready to answer.
Thanks, Mr. James, sir, for your comments, for your... I think tomorrow we will have a new professor to present. Let us see, I'm speaking with a new professor to present sometime for leadership management. We'll see tomorrow.
Okay, Mr. Anthony, thank you so much. The participants are very clear about successful interviews. Thank you so much for your presentation, and thank you, participants, your patience. And we will see tomorrow same time. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you all.